everybody, I'm Kirsty Meekin from Naio Nails, and guess what? We're doing Christmas nails! For the whole day. Oh my God, so excited. Hence, I have a red jumper on. This is about as Christmassy as my attire gets. But today, we're going to do, because I have a knitted jumper on, we're going to do a knitted jumper design! And love it when it's winter and Christmas time because we can do the knitted nails that have been going around for about, 5 years? They always come back round this time of year, so I do love doing them. We're going to do a little bit different, but oh, it's going to be exciting. So I'm going to start, and I'm going to do it over these two nails. So give you an idea of how you can sort of do this design yourself. I'm going to pop two tips on. When I'm popping that on, I'm popping it right at the very end of that nail. Ding-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-dong-ding. Ding-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-dong-ding. I'm going to cut down the length because I know Vanessa will not be able to cope with those. Do you know what you mean? About there, do you think? Oh, what was that? It's a little bit too long.
Yeah, that's about as long as the Halloween.
Yeah.
I've sussed it now, Adam. Typing with nails.
Alright.
I've got a silicone cover on my keyboard. Don't bug me now.
Because what did you say? It was slippy.
Yeah, and the clicking of the tapping, it drove me more.
A silicone cover?
Yeah, it just sits on.
So the nails don't slip.
It's meant to be like a protector for it so the crap don't get in there.
I'm just going to pinch that slightly just to make it a little bit more narrow. Uh-huh. So we get more of a we get more of a ballerina shaped nail. I'm just going to blend that in a little bit. And we'll do the same with this one. And I'm just going to wipe over with gel residue wipe off solution just to clean that up. You can wipe over with acetone if you want to melt that tip a little bit, but it's fine, it looks grand. Grand it does, it's grand. Dehydrate with the nail prep dehydrator. And then I'm going to use the Ultra Bond Acid Primer. Just on that natural nail, you can see that I've already prepped the nail, so I've removed the surface shine, I've done the cuticle work and all that. If you want to know more detail about how to sort of prep a nail, we do have videos with that on. I'm going to use medium speed liquid with the natural beige powder. This is a gorgeous cover powder. It is my favourite of the cover powders. And it's my favourite because it just covers really nice and it's really easy to work with. So I'm just going to keep stretching that to the end and working on the length first. Next bead, we can do the cuticle area, we can build up the apex. So I'm going to tip the finger down now. So notice I've changed the angle of my brush. I'm going to slide the product down. You can always rehydrate previous bead of acrylic as well with your wet brush. It just helps to slide that bead over the top and you get a great connection between each bead. Adam, have you asked Santa for anything for Christmas?
Not really, no. I've got nothing that I'm sort of, certain things I'd love, but I don't think anybody can afford them.
Yeah, I'd like a mansion as well.
Yeah, mine's just more about like
techie
toys,
stuff.
Toys, geeky toys.
Geeky toys.
Camera-y stuffy. Yeah. It's only about 50 grand's worth of stuff.
Oh, wow. No, neither. I'm going to do the same on this other nail as well. So you could do like when I show you the design, I think it's a nice design to be able to just use as accent nails. So the other nails could be just quite plain, and it could be all about those accent nails. And then that helps with timing as well when you work in the salon. You don't want to do like a full set of knitted nails. It may take some time, and in the salon over the Christmas period, it is a little bit crazy busy. I can come and pinch this nail now. So the first nail that I applied, we can pinch that one. We've allowed enough time for it to start to set up, and we can give it a little bit of a pinch. Is that hurting?
No.
Very good, very good. Now those are pinched and set, we're gonna file them. So I'm gonna file side walls, and then I'm gonna angle into that cuticle area. And then I can contour. Right, we're going to buff. I find some people skip this process, you know, buffing. I think it's so important to get everything nice and smooth. It softens everything. Then I'm going to wipe over with gel residue wipe off solution. So my background is going to be white. And this is where you know you need a killer tan, really, don't you? Sorry, Ness.
I didn't get what you said.
A killer tan, you need when you wear a white nail.
Tan? I thought you said time, and I was like, oh. Yeah, you do need a tan. Palest person on the planet or something.
So now I might beat you at that one. So I'm going to do both nails white.
It's quite funny when I put my arm next to my leg, it looks like they're from two different people.
Because the arm's been in the sun slightly.
Yes.
Pop me that in the lamp. And I'm going to do two coats of white. Ting-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling, tong-ding! What's your favourite Christmas song?
Sleigh Ride.
Sleigh Ride, what's yours?
Pogs.
Isn't that the really...
sad one?
Yeah.
Pop it in the lamp. So I'm going to use black, first of all. And we're going to do some knitting needles. Can you knit, Vanessa?
Nope.
I would have thought you would have been the knitting kind.
I'm not sure if that's a good thing or not. Did I seem like the knitting kind?
No, because you're creative. I just thought that you'd be able to knit.
I've never tried.
I used to be able to knit. My mum can knit.
And sew for England. I thought she was never going to stop sewing at one point.
Oh my God. Her fingers started to get really sore, and I think mum's fingers did, because she was just knitting. I mean, sorry, sewing teddy bears, making teddy bears out of clothes of loved ones who passed away. Cure me then. You don't need to be super, super black. I mean, I know that serious black is, well, seriously black, but don't worry if it's a little bit transparent, because we're going to go over this with silver. The silver we're going to use is Tarnished Silver from the Platinum Collection. This is super pigmented, so easy to use because of the pigment. We're going to go over, and I just want to leave like a little bit of black kind of showing through, as if it's like a little shadow. Right, I know they look like drumsticks right now, but you know, pop that in. Now for the jumper. The knitted jumper, we're gonna use Spardy, gorgeous. I don't wanna like this, I know it's Christmassy, but I wanna keep it like, not typical red. I wanna do something a little bit different, so we're gonna use this gorgeous color. Put some on some backing paper from Sculpting Form, I need a little bit there. I'm gonna use this little brush. And this is where you wanna start. So we're doing it as if it's open a little bit, because they are knitting the jumper. And fill the rest in with the brush from the bottle. It's gone blurry. Always gone blurry, Adam. And what we want is we want to make it appear as if this wool is going round the knitting needles. We want to do these little sort of curved lines. pop that on the lamp. And with a little bit, we're going to come do like a piece of the wool sort of stringing off. And it's going to go onto this nail. Do a little loop. And we're going to do the ball of wool. You're best sort of like painting the outside with your brush first and then filling the rest in. Put me that on the lamp. I'm going to mix a little bit of top coat with a little bit of black, which will just sort of make it like a transparent kind of grey. And this is just to add a little bit of a shadow where the ball of wool is. Just slightly darker when you come to the ball of wool. To get like a little shadow. Do a little shadow here. When you're doing your shadows, make sure they all go on to that same side, else it will look a little bit weird. You won't get a true shadow. And pop me that in the lamp. Into the lamp we go. Then I'm gonna go over with matte top coat.
I hated taking the decorations down. I hate taking them down. I feel like it looked very bare.
It does leave a room very bare, right?
It feels a bit depressing afterwards as well.
Right, pop me those in the lamp. Cause I want the knitting needles to be shiny, but everything else to be matte.
You're obsessed with that now, aren't you?
I am a little bit obsessed with that.
She hasn't done any matte bubbles yet.
Well, there's always time.
Okay, so.
And now for the exciting bit! We're going to use the gel polish, the same colour. We're going to do our little knitted pattern. This ball, we're going to do a line here and a line here. And there. We've got sort of three each side. Then we're going to do little shapes. And I'll do this kind of zigzag. I also want to add a little bit on top of those little kind of loops that go over the knitting needle. This is natural powder, not clear.
What's the difference?
You can use clear, it's just going to make it very, very slightly lighter, to be honest.
I'll sort of give it a bit of contrast.
Yeah.
Where the clear would just give texture.
Yeah. So you want to dust over it and the gel polish will absorb the acrylic powder. And that'll give it that textured effect. Cure that one for me. I'm going to do it like that. I don't want to do the other one and then do that one because you can guarantee I'm going to smudge that one. That would not be good. And for the ball of wool, I'm going to do little curved lines in different directions. So we've got those there and then we're going to have this one.
Sorry. I wasn't even a whisper, it was just a grunt, like a noise.
Coming this way, like this, and I'm concentrating so much. Oh my god.
and sprinkle, 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 sprinkle.
So we're going to dust over now. Look at that. That looks so cool. Love it. That's so cute. Vanessa was like, I'll be your model if you do me sweater knitted nails.
No, it was if it was Christmas.
And if it was Christmas, yeah.
So I was like, I may have something planned, but are we doing Christmas? And you said, yeah. I was like, oh, I suppose I'll come then.
But you wanted the sweater, didn't you? So I'm going to finish them with a little bit of cuticle oil. I've got the peach cuticle oil.
You should have a cinnamon one.
Ooh, yeah, we need Christmas scented oils. Naio nails, they need to go and get them sorted. I think my mother would approve of those.
Does your mum knit?
She's very good at knitting. We have spoken about this. You must have been on another planet at that stage. There you are, guys. Hope you've enjoyed this video and hope you're having a great winter slash Christmas. Because winter's just about Christmas, isn't it, really? Everything I've used today will be listed below. Don't forget to check us out on Facebook and Instagram, and I will see you in the next video. Bye-bye. Together with you.
Do we have any earplugs?
Outside the snow is falling and friends are calling you home.
I don't like Christmas to start with.
Well, you a Grinch.
Bah humbug here.
Nah, I don't mind it now. It was when I used to work in restaurants. Christmas was horrible.
See, you singing it now. Bar humbug over here.
I'm not a bar humbug. I do like Christmas. I do, honestly, but it's just...
drags out when it's like...
I like Christmas Day. I love Christmas Day. I think I love Christmas Eve. I love Boxing Day.
I hate
those 3 days are amazing. Everything else is annoying.